What do you want for Christmas, little boy?
This is Ultimately Possible Opinions with your hosts, Casey and Jay.
Don't piss me off, Art.
With a big ribbon on his head. And I want to look him straight in the eye, and I want to tell him what a cheap, lying, no-good, rotten, four-flushing, low-life, snake-licking, dirt-eating, inbred, overstuffed, ignorant, blood-sucking, dog-kissing, brainless, dickless, hopeless, heartless, fat-ass, bug-eyed, stiff-legged, spotty-lipped, worm-headed sack of monkey shit he is. Hallelujah! Holy shit! Where's the Tylenol?
All right, hey everybody, this is Openly Hostile Opinions. As usual, I'm Jay, this is Casey.
What's up everyone? Merry Christmas, you motherfuckers.
You'll notice an unfamiliar face here. This is...
Thank you.
Our buddy Mark Hammer.
Yes, Mark, how are you doing today?
Good. Let's say I'm honored to be on your show. This is awesome.
Yeah.
You got to get right up on that mic.
Yes. It's honored to be on this motherfucker. There you go.
This motherfucker right here. So Mark's coming to hang out with us, celebrate a Merry Christmas for y'all, and drink some beers.
Yes, yes.
Merry Christmas, is that the... political correct way to say that nowadays?
Okay, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Holy Kwanzaa, All Hail the Flying Spaghetti Monster, whatever you're into.
I was looking at Kwanzaa the other... Go ahead. I was looking at Kwanzaa the other day, and they like candles, too. What is it with lighting candles?
Candles are pretty.
They like candles, too? Why don't they fucking try something else?
It's like fireworks. Yeah. You know, and it's in the house, so there's danger.
Yeah, it's like fireworks.
Kids love it.
It's like fireworks for cheap people.
Yeah, that's true. Mm-hmm. I found fireworks today. I got some party poppers, finally. Thank fucking God. I've been looking for them all over the fucking place.
Yeah, so, I don't know if I consider them fireworks. You pull a string, there's no real fire. Yeah,
kind of like a tampon.
Yeah, you can just do that with a tampon. Pull it out and spin it around, make some tie-dye on the walls.
Gross.
So, Jay, do you want to introduce the beer this week?
All right, yeah, I suppose so. This week for our... we have one suggested to us by our buddy KP Smith. Thank you, KP. We have Sierra Nevada Celebration Fresh Hop IPA.
Yeah, I'll bring it up on the screen here. It's very, very Christmassy.
Christmassy.
Makes me want to, you know, fuck a snowman just looking at this.
That would be chilly.
Yes. Yes, it would. I'd get turtle dick real hard. It's 6.8%. Yeah. So let's go ahead and try this. Cheers.
Salute. Hey.
Cheers.
Happy Kwanzaa.
Ooh, that's good.
Ooh. That's delicious.
It's very piney.
That is good beer.
It tastes like their pale ale, doesn't it, a little bit?
Well, it's an India pale ale.
Yeah, doesn't it? What's that? It doesn't have like a green label or whatever. What's that? Is that what the
is,
their pale ale?
Sierra Nevada. But this is very piney, very citrusy.
Yeah.
I like it.
Oh, man, that is pretty good. It has really like strong aftertaste, very hoppy.
Right. So, Mark Hammer. Would you like to rate our beer out of 5?
What would you give this?
I would give this 4 hemorrhoids.
4 hemorrhoids.
Four hemorrhoids.
I'll go with that.
With all this holiday.
Long holiday.
Yeah. All this holiday food and shit like that, you're probably going to have hemorrhoids after we're done.
Okay, that's gross.
Yes, it is.
All right, so
welcome.
So, my little Christmas elf, do you have anything interesting for us to talk about today?
Yeah, we're actually going to talk about a fucking piece of shit jackass. This is what I think.
You mean other than the three of us at the table?
Yeah, I know. How about it? It's basically a video. This has been going around the internet, so people have probably seen it. But this guy basically, let me move this here, basically straps firecrackers to his chest and then lights them all. You know, let's just watch it here and laugh.
Hi, I'm Zacharias Holmes, and this is the suicide vest.
Hi, Zachariah.
Look at this.
I am never going to call myself fat again.
I know. This should be fun. Only Muslims did this, but...
You don't know.
What's that tattoo he has?
Is that a tattoo? It's it was a shirt.
It's the Triforce from,
Oh, that's, oh my god, it's only got one.
That's a tattoo, right?
That's the Deathly Hallows. You dumb fuck.
Oh man, it's great.
The fuck would possess you?
I don't know. Listen to him, he's in pain.
Well, no kidding.
I think he's very brave.
Would you do that, Amber?
Probably not with my shirt off.
Not with your shirt off.
Yeah, I'm not looking to advertise. This guy is the bravest motherfucker
I
know.
I like he lifts his boob up. He's like, am I burning my boob?
Or did the sweat put it out?
Yeah.
Oh my god, did you get that?
Yeah. Did you get it?
And he's worried about if you got it or not.
Oh my god.
That was... Oh my god, that hurt.
Oh my god, look at this guy.
Oh man. I had a little butt crack for you.
Oh. A little.
Jesus Christ had nothing to do with that, pal.
Yeah, I know. Hey, and there, it's sort of a holiday video because he says Jesus Christ in it. And he says it's horrible.
Well, yeah. No shit.
So there's also a video of him where he does the kiss of death, and it's where you take two tasers and you put it over your mouth. And, of course, he fucking goes, and he falls over.
Well, what part of that seems like a good idea?
I don't fucking know. To get famous, I guess. What jackasses put stuff on the internet to get famous?
Tosh, I don't know.
Tosh.0.
Yeah. Yeah, fuck those people.
Most famous show there is.
Tosh.0 is fucking... He's disgusting. I love it.
Yeah.
He helps me sleep at night.
Right.
Does he touch you where you pee?
Yes. Yeah, it depends. If you're two houses down the street. I was telling Amber about that. I was like, yeah, there's a child molester that lives in my town.
Yeah.
I'm like, hey, Amber's all like, what town did you bring me into?
The sad part is, when you moved in here, you know, we thought you were going to corrupt the town. No, you're the normal one here.
I thought I was the crazy one, and everyone else is just, like, fucking taking the prize, man.
Right, redneck, so it's pushing to the next Christmas level.
One and all! I figured after the child molester talk, we need to be a little festive.
Yeah. So, would you ever do that, Hammer?
What?
Would you ever...
The firework thing, right? Yes. I mean, no, I don't know.
Would you want to do that on the show for us sometime?
I think that would burn.
Have you ever done something
I hate being burned. Like, anything else, you know? You could stab me, but burning sucks.
Oh, that reminds
me. Nobody likes being burned.
That also reminds me. I remember working... We used to work together and everything, and you have a fear or a phobia of sticky stuff?
Yeah, stickers.
Really?
Like dirty tape and shit.
I've never really asked you about it, though, in detail. What is it?
I don't know.
Just because it sticks to your...
You know, when I was younger, those old Cabbage Patch kids.
Yeah.
I remember seeing them with hair and just shit stuck to them in school. And I thought that is the grossest thing. And it always kind of made me sick. Like,
really?
Just looking at it, yeah.
Oh, man. That's...
So, you know, we used to stick tape to them and shit.
Yeah, it's really dirty tape that really gets me.
It has to be dirty.
Yeah, because I can use a Band-Aid and stuff. But if it's like dirty, if I even see it, I want to throw up. Rico put one in his mouth at work and made me puke in a fucking trash
can. He put a Band-Aid in his mouth?
Yeah, a new one. It's hard to even talk about it. No.
That'd be my uncle, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen.
Just that you said that made me, like, weird, you know?
Got a little... Bleh.
I just remember that because I remember you were doing dishes one night and someone left gum or something on the plate. And you were like,
I don't know why. Like, you know, I'm not like the cleanest dude. So it just stickers and tape, like dirt. Oh,
that's hilarious. That reminds me of Eddie.
It's not hilarious.
Heavy cream.
Heavy cream.
Oh, yeah. There was this gay kid. There's nothing against gay people, but this gay kid and he fucking loved Casey.
Oh, yeah. He pissed me off one night. I was like, Eddie, I'm going to fuck your whole family. And he goes, as long as you start with me. I was like, son of a fucking bitch. And then Hammer was making fun of him one day. He made a milkshake out of heavy cream.
Well, he didn't put anything else. So it was
it was heavy cream.
Disgusting. And he was just making it at work. Like, one day he did it and it was fine. Yeah. And then next day he tried and it was like... What the hell did he goes, I ran out of milk, so I just used heavy cream. So we started calling him heavy cream. We thought that was the funniest shit ever.
We made raps about him. Yeah, it was stuff. Pretty hilarious. Like, his rap name was Heavy Cream. Oh, man.
You know the dream. His name is Heavy Cream.
Yeah. Oh, man. We should have recorded
that. And
album.
That's the way we said it, too. Heavy cream. Yeah,
heavy cream.
Oh, my gosh. It was so funny.
You know Heavy D? Well, you never met Heavy Cream.
Oh, man. I made him cry producing. One time. Oh, I made him cry one time. It was
one
so,
time?
Oh, it was so funny. We were backed up, and he's like, someone help me on dishes. And we're like, Eddie, fuck off, man. And he just bawled. Oh, never made a guy cry
he
before.
Did. Yeah, he did cry a lot, though. Yeah, I know. Over, like, the most, yeah.
Yeah, he was really young, so he was like, I don't know, a millennial. Is that the word we're going to use?
Yeah. Hate that word.
What does it mean?
Millennial?
Oh, that's the generation. Yeah. I just heard about that.
Yeah, me and Jay were talking about this. We're actually considered millennials.
Bullshit. Oh, really?
Yeah. By like 2 years or something.
No, I think you're after.
No, the age, there's a, what is it?
What's after Generation X?
Well, they say millennials, but some other people call it, there's a lost generation called Generation Y. That I believe
or
in.
Or like the hikers or something like that. They're hiker. Or
that's the
like
first I'm hearing
new
about
New age
it.
Hippies, all the kids that went to
yeah,
the
hipsters.
New Woodstock.
And yeah,
shit.
Yeah.
I thought that was a new generation or something they were called, but I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, we're labeled fucking millennials somehow. You're what?
I'm X. I'm Generation really? X. Yeah, that's old.
Why are they called Generation X again?
I don't know.
Because like, they were destined to just fail. That's the reason. That's
why
they called
it. Everything was done.
Really?
So it was like nothing left.
Nothing to
like
do.
X. Like, yeah. There's nothing, like, I don't
nothing
know.
Left.
Don't quote me on that shit. No, nobody. I just thought I heard that.
We're just here for the heavy cream.
Any cream we can get, really, at this point.
Yeah, that's true. So after that, Jay, what do you got for us?
Oh, let's see here. I got a couple of good ones. My first one, I don't know if you heard about this. So there's two very brave women who had to put up with something this holiday season.
Was it rape?
No.
Okay.
No, it was not. Oh, excuse me. Jesus. Fucking beer. They work in a adult bookstore, we'll call it.
Okay.
And some lovely human beings, very, very intelligent folk, decided they were going to try to rob the store. So a very ingenious lady behind the counter decided to thwart their robbery by pelting them with dildos.
Hey, man, if at least she stuck up for herself. Most people hide and cowered away and be fucking victims about it. I would throw fucking whatever I could, pocket pussies.
Yeah, well, that's what they did. I mean, he came in with a gun and they thought he was just joking. And then this is the best part about the whole thing. The store employee said, but then I saw the gun and I was like, really? I don't have time for this. Woman is badass. She has seen everything.
What else does she have time for? Do the pocket pussies need like certain oils rubbed on them every night?
She's like, I've got to fucking go clean out the private viewing booths.
Oh, I bet
they this hers out of her purse or was it still in a package?
I'm assuming they were ones behind the counter. But I mean,
fucking smacks
in
the face.
They have a box of them? Like, oh, half off these old dildos.
And, you know, that reminds me, a while back I saw they were actually doing like rent a dildo, they called it.
Oh my god.
So you could rent.
Did it have mileage counters on it so you could download it?
Because that would be the worst, getting hit by a used dildo. Like, oh fuck.
Like, oh, I smell vinegar now.
new one's bad enough.
Yeah, it probably had a box of old dildos and it says right on it, just in case of burglary.
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 Be like what?
Freshly glazed.
Yeah, freshly glazed. Like donuts.
Yeah.
Like
fresh donuts. Getting hit with a glazed dildo, that would discourage any robbery.
She'd start flaking off of it.
Yeah.
Well, that's my whole plan.
Like jizz dandruff.
Yeah, that's my whole fucking plan if I ever get robbed. If I ever get robbed by like five dudes, my plan is just to strip butt ass naked and try to rub myself on them. They wouldn't want to rob me.
My friend Rob came up with this. He was picking up dog crap, his dog, in a bag, and he's like, "I'll just hit somebody in the face with it." Like, warm manure hitting their face. Like, that would be the worst. Way you could put up with that.
Rob, was he the one that spit chew in some girl's mouth?
Hell no.
Who was that? Someone stole his dog or something.
Tom's.
Yeah, someone stole his dog.
His dog got away, and he found the people, and he's like, oh, you guys got my dog. Thank you. And they were kind of like, and then he realized the collar was off. Now, he had, like, tags and stuff on it, or stuff that cost money. And she goes, oh, I had stuff on it, so we threw it away. And he goes, you mean proof of ownership and tags and shit. He realized that they weren't, you know, finding his dog. They were stealing it.
Yeah.
And then he got really pissed. And then it was, I don't know, an African-American lady came down the steps and started yelling, and he had chewing. And he's a hick, and he spit it right in her mouth. And he was like, Darren, the kids come off a porch. He was mad. He was very upset.
That takes a little bit of talent to be able to get that arc just right.
He said he was close, and he was
Yeah, she was probably in his face.
Like, yeah, I'm sure it all didn't, it just went everywhere, but that was what he told me. He was so enraged because he realized what was going on. He goes, you threw the collar away. Why would you, who would throw
somebody's trying to steal your fucking dog is who would throw the collar away.
Exactly. It was in a bad neighborhood.
I've never met this Tom guy, but I've heard so many stories about it. I remember someone pissed him off and he flipped their car. It was like a RAV4 or something. I think it was his girlfriend or something.
Yeah, I don't know if he flipped it. It was like he jacked it up and then pushed it over.
Oh, really? Yeah.
So it was at least on its side.
Yeah.
Right. It was no longer on four wheels.
Right.
Oh, man, that's fucking great. I wish I could just flip a car when I'm pissed.
Back in the day, a buddy of mine we went to high school with, he had his car parked, and five or six of us all got around his car one time and just turned it sideways in the parking space.
Oh, man. And speaking of cars, my car fucking broke down. I have a truck, and the drive shaft fucking fell off of it. And I've been driving this standard car, and I'm so...
Mine.
Yeah. I feel like this car is like a transformer that was bullied and is, hiding away. And I had to go into town today, because I'm fucking... country boy or whatever the fuck you want to call it.
No,
it
is not. Fucking you just live out here.
I picked up Hammer and it's like stalling and I'm fucking trying to drive and it was god fucking awful.
Yeah, it's a little Ford Focus and it's got a bad math sensor in it, so it runs like
crap. And
I was
fucking on the highway trying to go 60 miles an hour. Fucking old granny that's 90, she's on oxygen, just going past me. It was fucking embarrassing. Oh, man, this
hey.
Oh, god. Hey, yeah, so I'm happy I'm giving that car back to you today too.
Hey, man, beggars can't be choosers.
I know. I'm just saying, man.
That was really nice of you, Jay. Good looking out.
Why, thank you. Thank you. I try.
Yeah, whatever. Fuck that car. I want a new car for Christmas, Mom.
Kathy, you're more than welcome to just smack the shit out of him.
Oh, she did.
I'm sure she'll do it again.
Oh, yeah. When I was younger, I pissed her off so fucking bad one day. So bad. And it was in the mall parking lot. She beat the fuck out of me so bad. I had her wedding ring diamond marks in my forehead. I forget what the fuck it was about, but she just beat the shit out. I deserved it, probably.
I bet she didn't do it again.
No, I was a horrible child.
Yeah, I was too. We all were. I know, dude.
I was a perfect angel.
Yeah. I fucking bet. Oh, man. Any crazy stories like that when you were younger? What's one of the bad things you did when you were younger, Hammer, that you feel bad about now?
I don't remember. There's a couple.
Everything.
Bullied some kids,
Bullied some kids.
Been dick. Just like releasing stress, and my brother and his friends beat me up, so I'd be like mad and take my anger. I'd pass it on down line.
Yeah, my brothers, they used to take old Walkman parts and duct tape them together and say they were going to blow up the house with me in it. That was my torture. And I was like, well, you guys will die too. And they're like, no, we have this special lotion we put on so we won't blow up. And I believed them because I was a little kid.
Special lotion. Yeah. That just got really X-rated.
Yeah, what the hell is your brother's?
I'm thinking we're uncovering some repressed memories here, Hammer.
Yeah, probably. But speaking of, sexual acts, our next thing here. I found a sex diary last night.
A sex diary? Yeah. The fuck is a sex diary?
It's just everything. A lot of this stuff is like the Dirty Sanchez and all this shit. But these are some I
you mean a sex dictionary?
I guess. I don't fucking know.
Whatever. Okay, all right. I
just picked some of the ones that I never heard of before. The first one we have here is an angry dragon. Immediately after you blow your load in a girl's mouth, smack the back of her head and make it come out of her nose. When she gets up, she'll look like an angry dragon. And, I wish we could get video sent in of people actually doing it.
I'm pretty sure if we look around hard enough, we can find video of this.
I know. Is this a like, a porn category? The angry dragon? Have you ever done this to a girl, Hammer?
What? Angry dragon?
Yeah, the angry dragon.
No, that's crazy. What is it?
It's when you blow a load in a girl's mouth and you smack the back of her head so the stuff comes out of her nose like a dragon.
Oh, like milk. when you laugh and spit up milk. Wow, yeah. If you could do that, that's a feat.
I know. We should get some videos of this. This one is just a name for another vagina. I've never heard of it. A bear claw. It's for extremely large pussy lips. Italian women, for some reason, have the biggest vaginas. Don't they?
I'm not going to comment.
Bye, ladies.
You want a stereotype?
All right, the next one we have here is the chili dog. This is fucking horrible. When you take a hot dump on a girl's tits and proceed to titty fuck her.
I did hear of that one.
You did hear of that one.
Y'all motherfuckers need Jesus.
Yeah. Oh, and since we raided our beer with hemorrhoids today, this one fits perfectly. The chocolate pizza, happily discovering hemorrhoids while eating a shitty brown eye. Oh, God, it's disgusting. They're like...
Yeah, you just got to grab them with your teeth and...
bite them like Starburst. The next one we have here is the cold lunch. The act of vomiting directly onto some chick's head while she's performing fellatio. Like, why do you got to use a fancy term like that?
I don't even know that cold is really all that accurate. I'm pretty sure it'd be sort of warm.
There was something else on there called a hot lunch, but I forget what that was. I didn't put it on here. Here's another one. This is fucking ridiculous. I don't even know how you have time for this. Would take a lot of planning. The flaming Amazon. This one's for all you pyromaniacs out there.
Pyromaniacs.
Whatever.
Words are hard.
Words are hard. When you're screwing some chick, right when you're about to come, you pull out and quickly grab the nearest lighter and set her pubes on fire, and then extinguish the flames with your jizz.
That's impossible.
That is impossible.
Like, how in the fuck would you even do that?
You know why that's impossible?
What is that?
Because this is 2016, and nobody has pubes anymore.
I know, that's true.
No, they have, like, you know.
Little patches. Runways. Yeah.
Nah. Little patch.
Dicks don't have sideburns anymore like they used to.
You know, if you have to, like, I always say if you have to clear cut the forest, then you might want to go and trim.
Yeah, exactly. Fuck that. Bitches getting
some women like to be empowered by having a hairy puss. I'm sorry, no men want to see your.
I don't.
I do.
Yeah,
I like it.
Yeah,
you go for the.
It could be hairy like 80s. That'd be cool.
You go for the Castro beard.
I wouldn't care.
Yeah, I don't care either. I took some girl's virginity one time. She had hairy pussy. I didn't mind at all. Like, she was really hot.
I don't mind.
Really focused on it.
I don't mind.
If she does have, like, a lot of hair, they should just call it, like, the caveman or something, you know, Neanderthal or something.
Captain Caveman!
Like, I already hit her over the head to get her here, so, you know, you might as well call it.
Right, the original Rufy. Yeah,
the original Rufy. Right? Yeah, I used to have a friend that used to wear a shirt that just said, bring back hairy pussies. I don't mind it either.
I'd be all about it. Like, honestly, it's cool.
Yeah, I know.
I don't mind a little hair, but when you got the shit that's, like, growing onto the thighs, it's time to take the weed whacker.
Yeah. The next one we got here is, this is just great, the Shirley Temple. Pour a can of 7-Up on a girl's menstruating pussy and eat her out.
Holy shit.
Throw some Band-Aids in there and hammer's good.
Oh, my God.
Please.
All right, we got one last one here. It's called the walrus. This is sort of like the angry dragon, I guess. After spunking in a girl's mouth, you pinch the center of her two lips together and hold her nose. This will force the cum to dribble out of the sides of her mouth, thus the teeth of a walrus.
Cuckoo, ca-choo.
Oh, man. Yeah, so I'm going to try some of these and get them on video.
You have to find a woman who's willing to let you touch her.
Yeah, that's true. Without caveman in her.
So this reminds me, I got into a debate with somebody not too long ago on Google+. Not really a debate, but somebody posted a picture.
Yeah.
It said something along the lines of, if you got done blowing a load in your woman, would you kiss her after? Or in her mouth, would you kiss her after? I'm like, yeah.
Nah.
Why not? It's mine.
It's already inside me. Like,
is that snowballing?
I don't know. Does
when
it have a name?
Spits.
Okay.
Oh, when she spits it back out in your
back
mouth.
Back in your mouth.
That, yeah, but I thought that was a woman
that's
thing.
That's not even like what they're saying.
Girl, it's... dude, to a guy. Oh, snowball. That's what snowballing is.
Oh, man.
I mean, that term. Huh? Why isn't that fucking there?
I forget who actually posted this posted this on here, but it's like, you know who you are if you're watching the show. I talked to you the other day on Google+. But yeah, I don't even see why that's a question.
Yeah.
It's like, it's mine.
Yeah, I don't care. That's like after a girl sucks your dick, you're like, oh, you kiss her? I'm like, yeah.
Yeah. Who cares? It's my dick.
Yeah, you can't taste it anyways.
Like, wasn't that on Clerks, like, talking about snowballing? That's where I learned it.
Oh, no, I've heard of snowballing before.
I'm not even saying.
I thought it was just two women that did it. I never heard about the man. No. That's fucking weird.
I'm not even saying swallow the load.
Like, really? I mean, man.
We're getting detailed here.
Transgender nowadays. I mean, really?
We're not even talking about swallowing the load here. We're talking about literally kissing your girl after she's.
Yeah.
Had your dick in her mouth.
Yeah, but I have heard of snowballing before, and that's when you, like, swish it around and stuff. Sort of like two girls, one cup, but not with shit. with semen.
I mean, I'm not exactly excited for the prospect, but I really don't even see the problem with that. It's mine.
Yeah.
How am I going to ask somebody else to put their mouth on it if I wouldn't?
I don't give a fuck. And the girls I know do a good job of swallowing, so it's not like there's any left on their lips. They're like, it's like after they eat good chocolate or something. They're like, did I get it all?
Got that Swiss shit.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's like, how the hell are you going to ask somebody to put your dick in their mouth if you're not willing to, like, deal with it after?
Yeah, I know. It's
good that you're a share, Jay.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because there was terms on there that I already like shrimping. It's when you come on a girl's feet or something. I hate feet. Ugh.
Fuck feet.
Ugh.
What?
Yeah, feet. I don't know.
Feet are gross.
Feet are sticky.
I mean, if you guys got a feet fetish, whatever makes you happy.
Yeah, I don't. I just don't like feet. Feet are nasty. They look like deformed. Like, I don't know.
Toes,
like,
are gross.
Yeah, like kids that grew up around the fucking nuclear power plant, and just ugh.
Web feet.
Yeah, web just feet.
The extra toes.
Yeah, I just don't like it. Ugh, no. Nope. I like girls' legs though. I think legs are overrated on a woman.
Underrated.
Overrated or underrated?
Underrated.
Yeah, underrated. Yeah. Did I say overrated?
Yeah.
Fuck. I can't fucking speak today. I have one job to do today, and I can't even fucking do it.
Yeah, literally, the only thing we do during this show is talk, and you fuck that up every week.
Fucking god awful. Hammer's doing better than I am.
Well, it's not hard, buddy.
You literally talk.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just not good at talking because no one listens to me.
You've been doing it for 30-some years. You think you'd kind of
develop but no one. Skill. I don't really talk to anyone. I talk in World of Warcraft. That's about it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You should be used to talking on the speaker. Anyway.
Which World of Warcraft's better than Hammer Online? Warhammer Online.
Love Warhammer. It fucking sucks, man. I loved it. I thought it was
You're like, it's better than WoW, though. It's going to be
bigger.
Draw.
I swore to him it was going to be bigger than fucking WoW.
Mark Hammer loved Warhammer. What a surprise.
Remember the old Warhammer was an old board game.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I played that one as a kid. When I saw it online, I was like, oh, yeah.
It lasted for a while. It just died out.
I thought it was better graphics, but...
I know, because you always called the WoW, they were like those square jaws.
Yeah, those motherfuckers.
Like, WoW is square people.
Square people.
Warhammer Online does it. They're still making video games, though. I don't think there's any MMO RPGs or anything, but...
I mean, as far as I know, I shouldn't even say that.
I played Final Fantasy XI. I was a real dork.
The new one just came out, didn't it? 15 or some shit. I don't know. I was never into Fantasy. I didn't like the whole churn-based thing.
Their MMO wasn't, but I like the whole SNES days. NES and SNES. After that, I don't really care. I'm not really much of a modern gamer.
Where they got really detailed, like white mage. Like red mage.
I just like back in the day, man. I play retro games still.
That's the one thing
Mario
I do
Kart,
miss.
I'm happy.
Now when a new video game comes out, you just download it. I miss like being younger and you're like, ooh, you know, getting to go to the store and pick it up. And like you got all your friends and you went. Now it's just like you download them offline and it's just like, ugh.
Right.
It's not as exciting anymore.
It's not like getting there and buying.
Yeah.
You know what I miss? Back when, you know.
Remember,
you had,
guys?
Remember? Remember when we had a Nintendo?
Remember?
And you had to go to the video store and rent a new game for the Nintendo, and you had the whole weekend you had to play.
Yeah, because you got it for the whole weekend, and you didn't know the game because online wasn't out, so you didn't know if the game was good or not. You just had to look at the back, and you'd be like, I don't know if this is going to suck or not. The graphics look good, I guess.
Hope this month's Nintendo Power tells you what to do.
Yeah, because you got the Nintendo Power magazine, and it would sort of say if it was good or not, and you'd just have to fucking play it. No one really knew.
Yeah, you know, you'd rent it, and you just hope to God that you can beat it during the weekend, and if not, then you write down all your codes to return back to the level you were. Yeah.
What video games did you play when you were younger? Did you ever play Tecmo Super Bowl?
No, I didn't like the little ones, except if they look like an arcade. Donkey Kong. No,
Now,
like those tiny little motherfucking arcades with the button. And, I don't know, like Atari, ColecoVision, fucking old stuff.
Hammer's old, so yeah.
We went to stores to get games. There was also this thing called VCR tapes. It was fucking crazy.
I remember VCR tapes. That's when I first watched RoboCop, one of my favorite movies.
Oh, that's awesome.
I love RoboCop. Fucking violent.
RoboCop is a great movie. And the new one's fucking garbage.
Don't even get me started on the new one.
But the first one was amazing.
I know. Violent.
So was Judge Dredd.
Oh, yeah. The new one even was good, too.
Yeah, the new one was good.
Oh, yeah. With Stallone. Everyone says that was a horrible movie.
It was a horrible movie, but it was entertaining.
It was violent. The new one's really violent. Slow-mo.
I Come in Peace. That was a really good movie with Dolph Lundgren.
Oh, man. Dolph Lundgren.
Speaking of that shit, yeah, it brings me to my favorite Christmas movie. Die Hard.
Oh, yeah.
Die Hard is a Christmas movie. Fuck
yeah, it is. Oh, yeah. I just seen a Christmas ornament that these people had, and it was a rectangular aluminum box and had a picture of him with a lighter crawled through it.
Oh, I saw that.
Yeah.
It's on an ornament. Yeah. The tree.
That's when he goes, God, now I know what a TV dinner feels like.
Do you know that they're doing a Chris Benoit story?
Are you serious? Yeah.
Really?
About how he killed his family?
I guess. I mean, that's he did be go the end shit. Of it anyway.
Oh, yeah, he did. Yeah, what'd they find? He killed his family. Did he kill his family?
Yeah.
And he killed himself?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. What it's all the steroid use.
Little kid and him.
Jesus. Yeah, it was in a hotel room, wasn't it, or something? No. Or am I just used to celebrities house. Dying in house, hotel
yeah.
rooms?
House, yeah.
No, he had a. It's from steroid use. It just fucked with
well,
his mind.
Well, that and his move was like a flying headbutt, so it gave him concussion.
Yeah.
For concussion.
So
like,
they think he just went
brain
nuts.
Brain damage, yeah.
Yeah, lots of brain damage.
So it's not going to be a documentary. It's going to be a movie.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
I'm sure they'll take some liberties with it. But
oh, probably.
So what are you guys' favorite Christmas movies? What about you, Hammer?
I don't know. I dig Elf because, you know, Will Ferrell, he's awesome.
I know. I love Elf.
I hate Will Ferrell.
I know. You do. You never liked him.
I love him.
That movie's okay, but I hate Will Ferrell.
Oh, I love it in that one movie where that guy's pissing him off. He's like, I'm going to shoot you in a dick with a flare gun. I can't remember what movie it was, but I lost it.
I don't know. Fuck Will Ferrell.
Yeah, I know
I hate
you.
Him.
Yeah, I know you don't like
He's
him.
He's not funny. He is not funny. I don't know what he did to Buffalo all you people, but he is not funny.
Buffalo? That's a term I've never heard before.
Yeah, it's my mom. Blame her.
My favorite Thanksgiving movie is Planes, Trains, and Automobiles.
That is a
really?
Good movie.
I love that movie, yeah.
Anything with John Candy's good.
The first right. Lethal Weapon I consider a Christmas movie. That's yeah. a good movie. I like it.
I thought your favorite Christmas movie was Christmas Vacation.
No, no, that's up there. That's
that
really
is
up
in the
there.
Opening credits of this fucking show.
Yeah.
No. Somebody should like it if you guys have
it. It's there. In my top five.
But I'm sorry, I grew up on it. I'd have to say probably Home Alone. It just those movies were so good.
Yeah, nowadays Home Alone be solved in 5 minutes.
They were good, though.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, just pull out the cell phone.
Cool.
Hey, Mom, you guys left me Home Alone. Okay, Kevin, we'll be back on the first flight. Okay.
That wouldn't have worked. Today,
yeah,
nope.
That doesn't
that storyline. You just want to text her real quick and be like, "You left me."
Oh shit!
She'd be like, "Oh fuck!" She'd be like, "I haven't left something like that since you know prom and I left a kid in a dumpster." But that's another story.
Oh, she came back and got you. Knock it off.
She wiped the coffee grounds and banana peels off your face, right. Brought
yeah.
you home.
Yeah, and that's why you know I am.
He
the
is
way
who
I am.
He is.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas, you filthy animal.
Thank you. That was my favorite line from that movie.
He's been waiting for me to play that all
that
day.
That is awesome.
Before the show, I was
Merry
like, Jay.
Christmas, you filthy animal.
I was like, Jay, you better get that fucking sound clip. That better be on the show.
And it's then beautiful. There's this one.
Isn't there anyone who knows what Christmas is all about?
Hey, man, you gotta rock the Charlie Brown.
Yeah, fuck
we
it.
All grew up with Charlie Brown.
Yeah. You grab that mic like you want to kill someone.
They should make, yeah, I know. They should make, you know, a sexual position for holidays, like the figgy pudding or something like that. Like the Christmas special.
Well, hey, let's do it now. What are we going to call
Christmas
the figgy
crosshold.
Pudding?
The figgy pudding, like that's just the most, I don't know. My brother and me were making fun of that the other day.
I remember.
I was like, what's figgy pudding? And I heard it in a Christmas song.
It's pudding like, oh, made it's... with figs, Hammer.
Yeah, I don't. Not.
You're like, no.
What, have you guys ever had figgy
no,
pudding?
No.
Have you
I've
ever
had fig
like,
Newtons.
Oh, I'd like fucking some figgy pudding today. That'd be fucking delicious.
No, it sounds British. I don't fucking know, doesn't it?
I don't think it's British. I just think it's like from the fucking 50s or before.
Yeah.
Well, you know, back in the 50s, people used to like take shit and suspend it in gelatin. That was a big thing.
Yeah, that's
like
right.
Like eggs and chicken.
That could
and
be
shit.
A sex position. Something with Jello. Call it the Bill Cosby.
No, it should be holiday themed.
Oh, yeah.
Like the Rudolph or something, you know, something crazy.
That's when you punch
where
a bitch
you punch
in,
the
nose.
Girl in the nose. Yeah, right.
I thought it was when she had her period. She sits on your nose, but whatever.
That would be yes.
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
The Rudolph.
Yeah, the Rudolph.
Trademark openly hostile.
I have a big nose, too, so that would work for me.
The Frosty.
Could you imagine doing
like, you know.
Could you imagine doing coke with this motherfucker?
Me?
Yeah, you put an 8-ball up each nostril.
Yeah, no one liked doing coke with me. Nope. I fucking took it all. I remember one time I did my name. Well, that's dating back some years. I don't do drugs anymore. Kids don't do drugs. They're bad for you.
If your kid's watching this show, then you're already in trouble. You're down the wrong path.
Dude, if there's parents letting kids watch this show, you failed as a parent. Or you didn't because you're awesome, but don't let your kids watch.
Merry Christmas, one and all!
Damn damn fucking right. I can't wait. I love Christmas. I used to hate it when I was younger, but I fucking love it now. Probably because I'm a depressed piece of shit, but whatever.
You're something else.
We're all depressed. I just don't hide it that well. Yeah, right, Hammer?
Yeah. No, I'm fucking pretty cheerful. I don't know what the fuck you lame asses are talking about. What the fuck?
Yeah, Hammer loves
it's
everything.
It's Christmas. Fucking cheer up.
Cheer the fuck up. I know, I have people at the bar that are like, fucking Christmas, I hate Christmas. I was like, cheer the fuck up, dude. God, I thought I was miserable.
You are, but...
I know, but whatever. But
not the... miserable, but he has like a down look on everything.
He does.
I do have a very negative
down,
look
yeah,
on things.
More... glass half empty, motherfucker.
Yeah, because someone asked me one time, they're like, Casey, why don't you want kids? I'm like, I am not working my ass off my whole life just to pay, get enough money to give to my kids so they're not stuck with my funeral. Like, and they're just looking at me like, God.
Real good way of looking at things, yeah. Buddy.
But that's the thing.
Have you ever thought of teaching kindergarten?
You're a fucking shining beacon.
Have
of
you
positivity.
Ever planned a funeral before? It is the worst
yes,
fucking,
actually.
Worst fucking thing in the world.
I'm sure.
It is horrible, and I horrible, never right. want to put a kid through that, ever. Ever. Nope, ain't doing it. I did plan one funeral one time, and it was for my dad. Never knew him. The fucker wanted more from me dead than he did alive. No, I was like, well, what happens if I don't have the money? Oh, we burn him and throw him in the trash. I'm like, oh, great. Like, no pressure.
It is cheaper to get him cremated.
Yeah, that's buried. What I did. Yeah.
This is the poor person's version of things, you know, when they go to have you identify the body, like, nope, I have no idea who that is. Sorry, Dad.
Yeah, I know. Like, I just hope I don't grow to look like him. Oh my God, he was horrible. He was so weird looking. I was like, I came out of that.
Says the guy with the giant nose and the hairline that's clearly
nose,
afraid of your
he
face.
Did, yeah, he did have my nose, I think. I can't remember. He was as pale as me, but I think that's because he was dead. Oh, I'm such a horrible person.
You do look like a fucking vampire, though.
I can't help it, man. Like,
we have pretty heavy stage lights on us here, because otherwise he looks like a damn vampire.
I don't know what it is. I just, sun makes me tired, so I don't think I get a lot of it. I don't know. There's people that I play well with, and they live over in California, and they're like, God, you're so fucking pale. I'm like, it's not 80 degrees and sunny all the time.
I would go to California.
It could be your heritage, you know. It's like Irish guys. They're pretty white.
Yeah, I think I
Scottish,
don't know. I think with
Scottish
this,
people are pretty white, right?
I think I'm English. Like, I think I got a lot of English in me, and I think that's where this fucking nose comes from.
Right on.
Like,
very regal.
Yeah.
Very regal.
Regal.
Yes.
What was that wrestler's name?
Yeah, it's quiet.
Steven Regal.
Dun, 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 dun. He'd come out. And he'd
Hammer's our resident WWE.
I don't, you know, I'm not really watching anymore, but I do, like, I don't like it
yeah.
so much. When I was younger, I loved it.
Oh, I loved wrestling, too.
Yeah,
I remember you showing me some of those divas. Divas are getting really popular
right,
right now.
They're
fucking
like the
smoking.
They're
who was your guy? Who was your guy back in the day?
Who, me?
Oh, Triple
Hammer.
H.
Oh,
H.
yeah, I loved
Triple
it.
H.
He was such
he
a
was
scumbag.
A
yeah,
I was a Mick Foley guy.
Yeah, he
oh,
was
I
good.
Love Mick Foley,
yeah.
too. I mean,
I like
Hell in
Triple
a Cell
H,
is probably one of the most
oh,
entertaining
yeah.
matches
the Undertaker.
I've ever watched. That's crazy.
That was insane.
Yeah, the Undertaker. I love The Undertaker.
He
Hacksaw,
was,
Jim Duggan.
Yep, he was my favorite. Undertaker was my favorite, but Triple H was up there because I liked him like you did.
He
was just
a dick.
Dick.
The best dick
he
in
took,
the game.
Yeah, he took what awesome. It did to win. Like he'd bring out sludgehammers and take their knees out and stuff just to
he
win.
He was fucking China for a while.
Probably.
So what?
China
right
was
on.
Fucking giant.
After all the after all the plastic surgery, she was pretty smoking. She looked like I don't know. She looked like a dude beforehand,
man,
but after all the plastic
die?
Surgery,
yeah
she's dead.
She did porn.
Did she?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Dude, after all the plastic surgery, she was actually kind of smoking.
Be like fucking
she was
Ferrigno.
Like really, when she was a kid, I guess she got picked on so bad, she had no friends, and she would just go home and do the Jane Fonda workout tape.
Really?
And then she'd rewind it and do it again. Like, that's all she did is just sit at
hey,
home
when
and exercise.
People pick, see,
because she had
yeah.
no friends. Like, she was horrible. She
what,
it was
yeah.
horrible. Her up, I don't know, growing up.
Well, that's like
with
you
that
told
big
me.
Jaw.
Yeah,
you could tell she had jaw. So
oh great. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Well, that's like you told me about Jackie Chan. Hammer's a big kung fu fan, like I am, and he was
love
telling
it.
Me about Jackie Chan grew up really rough life.
Poor,
yeah,
really poor.
Poor
in an orphanage that was so bad they shut it down and turned the kids loose on the streets.
Yeah,
because that was a better alternative.
Yeah.
Than the orphanage because they would whip them and make them, you know, do acrobats and circuses.
Mm-hmm. And tell us why. I remember you told me this story, but go ahead and tell the viewers why is Jackie Chan's movies funny? Remember you were telling me about that because of Bruce Lee.
Oh, yeah, because he had to go against Bruce Lee. So mm-hmm. Bruce Lee, he said everything opposite. Like, he was so serious, he had to be goofy. Mm-hmm. You know, he's like, his kung fu had to be just like, he was mostly hands, and Jackie Chan was trying to be mostly feet, because he said, I had to do the opposite, because I couldn't be compared to Bruce Lee.
Yes.
He goes, I wasn't getting a job.
Yeah, you can't be Bruce
pretty,
Lee.
Like, his biography is pretty awesome.
Yeah, he's, I just awesome, thought that was dude. Interesting. Yeah. Like, if you can't, you know, beat or be as good as them, do the complete opposite. And that's what
he
I like.
He said he had to. There yeah. was no choice. He was, like, not getting jobs.
Well, that makes sense. You look at the Drunken Master movie, that last scene where that guy with the fast mm-hmm. feet in the foundry, like, that's all feet.
Yeah, like the Jackie whole... Chan is the original badass.
He oh, yeah, I love him. Crazy. It sucks he's getting older, because I'm but Tony Jaa, or
his
however
son,
you say his name, is really
stuff.
Cool. Oh, really?
Yeah, he has a kid now. It's in Kung Fu.
I'll have to check that out.
Yeah.
Chocolate, one of my favorite kung fu movies. Chocolate is about a girl with autism. And
I have that because Casey
that
told
movie.
Me about it. I went out and bought it. It was
fucking great.
Awesome.
If you're a kung fu fan, check out Chocolate. It's a girl with autism, and her mom's dying of cancer. So she basically kicks...
Sounds like the feel-good film of the century.
Yeah.
It is. It's crazy.
Well, she just watches kung fu movies.
And plays kung fu games.
Yeah, and she just basically, like, these people owe her mom money, so she goes and beats them up for it, and it's fucking awesome.
Well, that works, I guess.
Yeah, and one of the greatest scenes is she fights a guy with Tourette's syndrome. he has full body Tourette's, and she can't figure him out because he's so sporadic, and it's a great fucking scene, dude.
That was her nemesis.
Yeah,
Tourette's.
He was just funny. She couldn't predict him. She was so smooth with everything because, you know, she trained a lot, and she couldn't
was like Rain Man with kung fu.
Yeah, it was just awesome. Oh man, what was the other Fist of Legend?
Awesome.
That was one of my favorite
ones.
Yeah, Jet Li back he's in the day. Phenomenal. I love where he fights that old man blindfolded.
Yeah, that's one of the best.
I don't like kung fu movies, but I'm not an expert on them like you two are.
I mean, I'm just a fan. Just fan, love them. They're fucking awesome.
I don't mind the subtitles at all.
If you like kung fu, like the Wu-Tang, they love kung fu.
Oh, fuck yeah. He was in The New Protector.
Yeah, he's in a lot.
He's the main Iron Fist.
Yeah. That's badass.
He was the main bad guy in The Protector. Is it Tony Jaa or Tony Jala? I don't fucking know how to say it, but he's awesome. No, he's like the new Jackie Chan. He does all of his stunts. The girl from Chocolate does all of her own stunts, too. She's like really young and like, I don't know. It's crazy. How'd we get on kung fu?
Jay.
Did I?
No, I don't know.
I'm fine with it.
Casey brought Jackie Chan.
Yeah, we were talking about wrestling.
Wrestling.
Oh, that's right.
You want to wrestle?
Is the backyard wrestling going on anymore? You told me you were going to some of those.
Yeah, I went to a couple of them, and they were pretty cool, but I don't know, like, the guy that was running it kind of ripped the wrestlers off, so now they started up again, you know, with a new guy, so, you know.
Because I remember you told me that you and Brooks were going to do an Amish wrestling
team. Me and Brooks,
team.
Yeah, wanted to be Amish wrestling team.
He does have an Amish beard.
Yeah,
and you said you were going to come out and yell at everyone for using electricity.
Like, we were like, Brooks came up with a... What is the saying? Oh, when the Amish brothers are in town, the lights go down. I was like, we were going to do moves, you know, like, I don't know.
The butter churner.
Yeah,
and
the
stuff.
Butter churn. That was going to be a hold. And like just whatever funny we could think of.
Oh, that's
man,
pretty
that's
good.
Yeah.
Churn into butter. That was it.
Churn
into
butter.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I churn the butter from time to time.
Yeah, me too.
A couple times a week, whether I need to or not.
Yeah. Damn right. You're like,
I am married.
That's child's play.
Oh, out of all of us, Jay's the married one out here.
Why is that strange?
Every guys are fucking. No, I'm just saying, there's not many married dudes
anymore.
Our age, yeah.
Nah, it's not.
All my friends are single.
Yeah.
Pretty crazy.
Yep. They're just, I don't know. That just works out that way.
Just nerds. We'll
everyone
care about games.
Yeah,
nothing
I
else.
Know.
Like, they don't leave the fucking house. They're as pale.
I know. I remember when everyone used to be married. Now it's like.
Now
that's,
it's not the thing.
Yeah.
To be married.
No one's married anymore. They stick together for maybe a couple of years, and oh my goodness, that's
exactly,
weird.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
How long has it been, Jay, since you've been married or married for?
God damn it, Casey! Why would you ask another man?
She doesn't watch the show, so you're good.
Yeah, she's not gonna know, Jay.
I know you
have to watch this whole segment to be in on it.
I know you were married in October.
Hang on.
Oh god, she's gonna kill you. I don't. Oh man.
Well, Jay was married. Our next segment will be what not to bring up on fucking talk radio.
I'm going to say six years, something like that. We've been together.
That's it? I thought it was plus 10.
Oh, we've been together for well over 10.
Holy fuck. I thought you were married for 10.
No. We've been together for about 10 years. Probably about 11 or 12 now, actually. 12 years.
Right on.
Yeah, congratulations, man, because I can't even keep a relationship together. It's because I'm a selfish, heartless cunt.
I was going to say, it involves, you know, not being a selfish prick.
Hey, man, I was a beautiful plant when I was growing up, and then just fucking plant. People blocked the sunlight from me.
He is Groot.
Yeah. People just fucking, I don't know, just...
I just heard a girl refer to weed as the devil's lettuce. I was like, that just made me think of that. I was like, devil's lettuce.
The devil's lettuce. That's pretty good.
I thought
she's young too. She's like 18.
She's probably some fucking
like, devil's
vegan.
Devil's lettuce. Is that what you kids call it?
Yeah, we have a friend here who last night just said the funniest fucking thing ever to me. I'm not a big fan of vegetarians and vegans, mostly because of their attitudes. But yeah, she called it an eating disorder.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah. That's funny. She was saying that.
If you're watching, Michelle, that's pretty fucking funny.
Yeah, when she said that, I was like, yeah, it's pretty funny. Yeah, but I guess what she was saying was they're actually starting to label it as an eating disorder.
It should be considered a fucking eating disorder.
Yeah.
What is being a vegetarian?
Being a vegan.
It's a choice.
You need. Well, it's a bad choice.
What they're saying is a lot of... families are starting to do it, and they're doing it wrong, and they're killing their children. Like, we covered it on one time. They weren't doing it right to this kid, and he needed, you know, different nutrition, and they killed him.
Nourishment and shit.
Yeah, because they were just trying to feed him like nuts.
Or no, he didn't die. They managed to get that one away in time.
Oh, okay,
See, I wouldn't want to push on a kid.
Yeah, I know.
I'd let them make that
People
decision.
Do that, though.
I mean, if they're growing up with hippies, they're probably going to go that route anyway. Yeah. No, but that's reason to choice. Throw them into it. Yeah, no reason to throw them into it at a young age. I mean, unless you want them to be clean, unless you study it, you know, you want them to be healthy and clean and you're good with it.
Well, that's the thing. Like, there's a way to do vegan, and a lot of people don't do it.
I don't know. How do you do it wrong? That's crazy.
I don't know.
No nuts. No
But then that's like vegetarian.
We can't have eggs, right? You can't have eggs.
No, nothing from an animal. Right. Nothing from an animal. That's actually, we should cover one time. But there's
Can
this...
you swallow if you suck dick? That's my question.
That girl that put semen on her face that we covered that one time, she swallowed it, didn't she?
Well, yeah, she put it in her smoothies and shit, but that's one person.
Yeah, we covered a girl that...
Jesus.
Yeah, and she put incense in the house because it smelled her house up and shit.
Well, I mean, you know what it smells like when you get the old crusty sock out.
Yeah, she was really good looking, though. Like, it really, she had smooth skin. She had...
Yeah, it might be something to this.
Yeah, like, she's like, yeah, I get it from my friend, and he gives it to me, so I drink it, and I put it on my face. She's like, I need some...
Okay.
Get a little grossed out.
Yeah.
All right, boys and girls, you want to get into our game? We have a game for you today.
Oh, that's right. We do have a game today.
Yeah, we're going to play another round of Would You Rather.
Oh, God, this fucking shit again.
This time, though, our punishment for if we get the answers wrong, we actually get a chance to not have a horrible thing happen. We're going to play Bean Boozled.
Oh, great.
We take beans and shove them up our ass for every wrong answer, and you got to hold them there all day.
Like a little hammer.
This here is Bean Boozled. And you get a spinner here, and you either could end up with coconut or...
That's a figgy pudding.
Yeah, there you go. Or spoiled milk, or caramel corn, or moldy cheese. We have no idea which one we're going to get.
There's not a rotten potato one on there, is there?
No, but that is the worst thing.
Because I will straight up fucking vomit.
Berry blue or toothpaste, lime or lawn clippings. Let's see how this goes.
Oh, great.
Let me make some room here. Make some room. We got to do the spinner and all that happy crap.
Oh, there's a spinner?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, my God.
It's like the Wheel of Fortune.
It's the Wheel of Sadness.
Yeah. Did you hear about that?
No.
Wheel of Fortune, they got caught rigging their wheel.
Did they really?
Yeah.
No way.
Yeah, this happened like a year ago, didn't it?
I would imagine they would do it to make them win better prizes so people watch more.
I don't know. You'd lose money, though.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, no, uh-huh. If it was like maybe they're sponsored.
Yeah, I don't know.
You know, like, oh, you get a new Ford Focus.
Yeah, that could be. All right. We're going to play Would You Rather.
God, there's a bunch in there.
Okay, if it goes in the middle like that, it's just, you know.
We'll spin again.
Second spin.
Yeah, we'll spin again.
Don't point at me.
Don't
point at me, you piece of shit.
All right. Let me pull up our Would You Rather app.
Oh, we got an app now?
God, we got an app now.
God, those jelly beans look good. I want to eat some now.
Yeah, the green ones look good.
I know.
They're always my favorite.
Look at that blue one. It looks like the
ocean.
Oh,
that's lawn clippings. Fuck.
All right. First question.
Where'd you pick something up like that? There's the first question. Where the hell did you get this?
Grocery store.
Oh.
All right, first question.
Like a sex shop or something.
Got dildos thrown at me, sorry.
Jesus Christ.
Did you ever see that one where they fucking guy was coming at a sex shop and all these cameras were around and they present him a giant check for a free dodo? He was so pissed. Yeah, his reaction was just so mad. He's like, oh, they're like coming up and like, they had the old fashioned cameras that were flash photo. I mean, he was like, just came out and was like, what? He was blinded by it. And they're like, sir, you're a 1,000 customer. I was like, what the fuck?
Oh, that's great.
That was so funny.
Oh, man.
All right. Sorry, Jack.
We're starting out savagely.
Oh, great.
Would you rather have your limbs pulled in opposite directions until they rip off, or be hung upside down and cut with a saw down the middle from between your legs?
What's the first one? Have your limbs pulled off, like horse,
like Braveheart style.
Like the old day, I take that. The horse.
What was the second one? Read the second one again.
Be hung upside down and cut with a saw down the middle from between your legs.
Yeah, the pull from limbs.
Yeah, I'm going with that.
Yeah, no balls.
Did you guys see that new movie? Bone Tomahawk.
Yeah, I love that.
That's a good movie.
See where they cut that dude like that?
That is a great movie.
All his innards.
Yeah, a little off. Yeah, like watch that movie. It's a great Kurt Russell's
in it. Bone Tomahawk. Yeah. That is a good movie. So, awesome western.
So what was the?
Yeah, we were right. We went good here.
All right, we won.
All right, hang on.
There's a
what would you call it? A hive collective.
Yeah, like the major.
Sort of like Family Feud.
Yeah, the major majority vote.
Yeah.
All right, so would you rather lick somebody else's armpit or have someone else lick yours?
Have someone else lick
mine.
Obviously. 91%. It's not even close.
9%.
It's a 9.
I like mine. I like to lick an armpit instead of have mine licked. Who the fuck says that? Oh, yeah, I'm going with the first one.
Would you rather be rich from selling drugs or just get by with a legal job?
Rich.
Rich selling drugs. What the fuck?
Oh, we're wrong.
47-53. What? Get a job with it. Wow, thank God, people. A
bunch of Christians
honest
playing
motherfuckers.
This.
All right, we have to either do buttered popcorn or rotten egg.
What's it look like?
It is...
Oh, rotten egg. Are you fucking kidding
me? Yep, yep. It's yellow. It's yellow.
The yellow one?
Yep, grab a yellow, boys. One of these ones right here, the smooth yellow.
God.
All right. All right, try it. Oh, I got the egg.
I don't know what I got.
Oh, that's fucking gross.
Yeah,
that's... mine's not that bad.
Yeah, you got the good one, probably.
Do you just taste like popcorn or an egg?
Butter.
I don't know what mine tastes like.
Oh, no, now it's strong tasting.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, that's... you know what? I think it might even be popcorn. It's just gross.
Yeah.
I don't know what mine is.
I don't think you fucking win at this game.
All right, next question.
It's a horrible aftertaste.
Oh, yeah, that is all. I think it's popcorn.
The more
you chew
it, the stronger it gets.
I don't know what that is. It doesn't taste like any of that.
Yeah, I'd rather shove it in my ass.
That doesn't
it tastes like shit.
I know.
Exactly. And I don't know what shit tastes like, but this is
That doesn't taste like egg or popcorn. I don't know what
it
the fuck.
It just tastes gross.
Yeah, that was just horrible.
Yeah, it's punishment.
All right, would you rather fight a wolf with your bare hands or fight a vicious bear with a knife?
That's a tough one. I'm going with wolf.
Yeah, bears, I'm going wolf.
Bears have too much fat.
I'm going to go bear.
All right. Well, we'll see. Hammer won. Casey and I did not.
How did Hammer win?
I'm spinning.
Bears have so much fat on them, even if you stab it once, it's not going to do anything.
Do you want to know my reasoning?
Why?
Yes.
The movie The Edge.
Oh,
with
okay.
With Anthony Hopkins. They take the fucking bear out with a spear. What one man can do, another man can do. Say it with me. Watch that movie. That's what he says in the fucking movie.
All right.
It's chocolate or...
Or coconut.
No, what's that saying?
Coconut or spoiled milk?
Coconut, yeah. Coconut or spoiled milk. So the white
They're
ones.
The white ones, yeah.
Go for it, Case.
Yeah,
go
you got
Jay.
It. White.
Let me Is see. Yeah, white? I want the fucking proof, too.
That's a verify.
All right, yep.
All right.
Go ahead. Enjoy.
Coconut.
What is it?
Spoiled milk. What the fuck?
That's gotta be the nat. I still taste that fucking nasty.
I know that one was horrible.
Fucking.
Beans. Why would they make these?
I don't know. This coconut one's actually.
I feel
pretty
like
good.
I'm winning.
I'll just take a sip.
Nobody wins. You just get a little bit better each day.
Yeah. Coconut.
Okay, next one.
Would you? Well, this is fucking stupid. Oh, whatever. Would you rather be killed by a shark or killed by a crocodile?
I'm gonna say shark.
Why?
Because a crocodile does that death roll and tucks you under and waits till you rot before he eats you. I'd like to get it over with and like, if you're gonna fucking eat me, go ahead and eat me.
Okay, bro. I agree with you there. That makes sense.
I don't know, man. That's a fucking tough one. I'm going with
a death roll. It's
I know, but sharks just fucking shred you. Right.
I don't know. Pick one. I want to get the milk out of my mouth
immediately. You're
actually,
not gonna be tortured.
I would do a shark because you'll probably drown. And you just pass out when you drown, so you probably won't feel a lot of it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Shark, all right. So shark.
Definitely shark.
70-30. We got that one right.
Good call, Hammer. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Would you rather get punched in the head once a day or get beaten up to a critical condition once?
Beat up to a critical. God, I can't talk to that critical condition once.
I'm going to take punched in the head.
Once a day.
Yeah.
I think I have a hard head.
It's not gonna, you know what I mean?
I know, but it's annoying.
I think I'd rather.
Oh, it's 12:30. Got to get punched in the head.
I think I'd rather get punched in the head once a day.
It'll keep you tough.
I don't know. That's annoying.
I could deal with the headache better than I could deal with a critical condition.
I don't get
headaches,
so that's another thing. I never got a headache in my life.
All right. Well, we're okay.
We fucking lost.
Yeah, me and Hammer. All right,
I go ahead and spin.
Okay, Casey, you'll spin.
Ow!
Same one.
Peach or barf? Oh,
right,
that should be
what
good.
What color is it?
It's like fucking, I don't know. It looks like barf.
It's the robin egg looking the spot. Right. Oh.
Here, he says you
know.
There's
actually
like
two that look like that for some reason. I don't know how to tell the difference.
That's it, right?
No, there's like two.
Let me see.
See?
No,
I think
that's it.
No, it's the lighter colored one here.
No, it's the lighter one. Okay.
No,
it's those. Trust me. No, that's the strawberry banana or the dead fish.
All right.
What is it, peach or barf?
This is definitely peach. I got peach.
Did you get peach or did you get barf?
I got peach.
All right. We survived.
Oh, you
fucking... It's not bad. It's like not.
Okay. It's actually pretty tasty.
Yeah, it's actually.
Yeah,
it's better than that rotten milk one.
And how do you get the fucking barf?
Whatever that first one was hell.
Yeah, I know. That was horrible.
I think it was supposed to be buttered popcorn and it just tastes gross regardless.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck that was.
In the end, though, they all kind of this one tastes nasty again. It's, I don't know.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I'm still getting a delightful peach.
It was good in the first place. What's the next one?
All right. Would you rather have uncontrollable gas at work for the rest of your life or have uncontrollable gas on every first date for the rest of your life?
Or
the date.
I'm going for work because fuck my coworkers.
Why would you do the date thing?
Because it's only once. The first date, right?
No, every first date.
Every first date.
So if you hook up and you like
the way women
one,
are though, you're
gonna
have a lot
one,
of first dates.
Well, then they deserve to be fucking parted with.
You know, Hammer does make a good point.
You do make a good point.
You know what? Fuck it. I'm going work because fuck my coworkers.
Yeah,
work's more important. Come on, you're not gonna get that first date unless you have a fucking job.
All right, Hammer, spin the wheel of death. It's your turn. All
right. Wait, who won?
We did.
Oh yeah,
Hammer's got it.
Oh wait, I won.
Let me
you seal your own fate.
Did
Hammer.
I win?
No, you lost.
I'm going to spin for him then.
Okay, go ahead.
Chocolate pudding or canned dog food?
Imagine
it's the black one.
Black
ones. Yeah, it's like the blackish
I don't
looking
mind
one.
I don't fucking dog food. Is it just me?
Yeah, it's just you.
Just you.
You're like, I don't mind dog food. Fuck it. Chocolate pudding or dog food?
Dog food.
That's it. How bad is it? I can smell it.
It's not that. I mean,
I can smell
it's not
it.
Not good.
Yeah, there's nothing.
It smells like those veggie burgers. It does a little bit. Is that what it tastes
like? Yeah, it's like.
I can smell it.
Kind of like a.
Holy shit.
I don't want to say mildew, but.
Mildew.
You know what I mean? Like fucking.
Yeah, I can smell.
Strong ass dog. Food.
It smells like an old basement.
Alpo and shit.
Yeah, Alpo.
Sponsored today.
Man, these people are fucking brutal. Would you rather get hung by a noose or get decapitated by a guillotine?
Guillotine.
Quick and over.
Quick and over. Yep.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah, quick and over.
Okay, it wasn't even a contest. It was 73-27. Would you rather be fisted by the Hulk or fisted by Wolverine with the claws out?
Ooh.
Oh.
That's a tough one.
This is two bad situations.
I can't imagine being fisted.
I know at all. At all. Like, screw the Hulk.
Even by Jimmy Small Hands, it would be pretty
bad. Oh, man. That's
like Deadpool,
a fucking...
his girlfriend.
That's a tough one, dude. I have no fucking clue.
I'm just going to get it over with. I'm going to say I'd rather, I guess, I don't know.
Oh, I'm saying
Wolverine.
The Hulk. I'm saying the Hulk, the blades. The blades are going to do more damage.
Right. I'm going to say Wolverine just because I might die before it's over.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, I'm hoping for the worst. Like, all right, I want to die.
All right, I'll go with that. Oh, we fucked up.
Oh, we lost.
Fisted by the Hulk, 76%.
Yeah, because those blades are going to go up and they're going to fucking kill you.
All right, we'll see what our fate is. We got Tutti Frutti or Stinky Socks, and it's the really funky looking pink and blue one.
Stinky Socks or what else?
Tutti Frutti.
Tutti fucking Frutti. Do you remember that movie?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that must be it. And Casey gets one too.
No, I picked Hulk.
Went Hulk.
Yeah, okay. Don't fucking do that.
As much as I'd like to see him suffer with us,
I got socks.
Oh, great.
Yeah, I got shitty
too. Really? Yep. Now what?
No, I definitely have socks. It tastes like cotton.
Is it clean? It tastes like.
Now it's getting really bad.
Yeah.
It's getting worse.
How bad is
it? I'm fucked. I've been eating these shitty things all day. Can't wait till I go to work and have the farts.
Oh my god.
Mark, what? I'll be like, oh, I don't know. It's weird smelling.
Like, your farts smell like dirty socks. Be like, I don't know. It smells
like fucking a mixture of dog food and fucking boiled eggs and shit.
How the hell do they make them taste like this? This is ridiculous.
That's what I'm like. Where do they get the flavoring from?
Would you rather drown or suffocate? Isn't it kind of the same thing?
It is the same thing. Yeah, because when you drown, you suffocate, basically.
I'm going to pick drowning.
Yeah, drowning.
I'd rather suffocate. No, fuck water.
No, I'm going with suffocate because I think a majority picked.
I think you're right, but I feel.
All right, yep. Well, Hammer's got to do it.
All right.
Seal your own fate.
A peach or fucking barf? That was the worst, dude. I'm not looking forward to this. Is that the
one? That's the one.
Yeah, but last time you got peach and you thought it was gross.
There you go.
I don't even know. It was so horrible. God, I do not want to do this.
Peach or barf?
Barf.
Oh, man. That must be strong because every time you do it, that face.
Where the fuck's the bottle opener?
Oh, it's right there. It's right there. Is it that bad, huh?
It really is.
Do you need another beer?
They got Mac from finding this. No,
he has one.
On
the second. Oh, jeez. That's what I think would be the worst is the barf. That's too much. Yeah,
horrible.
All right. This is actually a pretty good one. Would you rather be in an arranged marriage or spend your life single?
I'm already spending my life single, so that.
I'm going to go with arranged marriage.
I'm going to take arranged marriage. Just because that'd be fun. Like, oh, I get to make somebody miserable.
Yeah, you know what? I think if you're around somebody long enough and you're forced to be, you'll grow to deal with them. You'll grow to appreciate them.
I don't know. Look at that 90 days thing we covered. That was,
Let me get one of my farts.
What if she stinks?
Yeah, but he still had the ability to walk away.
Yeah,
if
don't.
You didn't.
I'm doing arranged marriage because we can get a divorce.
All right. We're all going the arranged marriage. All right. Marriage.
We narrow margin. 51 to 51. Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah, that's all right. All right, next one. Would you rather rip out your toenails or rip out every hair on your body? I'll take the every hair on the
every
body.
Every hair on my body.
Hair.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would hurt less. Okay, we're good.
Oh, thank God. I don't want that barf.
Would you rather eat someone's heart or eat someone's liver?
Liver.
Liver, because you might get drunk. I don't know.
Liver, because...
No, I'm going to take heart. I'm going to reverse that. Are you taking liver?
Yeah.
I'm taking liver. Heart. Just because liver's already liver? Food.
Okay.
54 to 46. Hammer? Damn. Quit trying to be a rebel.
Here, do you want
to
do it yourself?
Yeah. Yeah. You want to do it? Here, take it, motherfucker.
Do it for me. Come on, line.
What's that? Chocolate pudding or canned dog food again?
All right.
You're like, I've had this one before. Fuck it.
I ain't going to deal with that one.
Not good.
God, you're getting unlucky, man.
I think we're all fucking unlucky.
There's no good flavors. There's only sadness. Would you rather gouge out your own eyeballs or cut open your arteries on your wrist? Well, obviously, gouge your eyeballs out. If you open your wrist, you're done.
Yeah. Eyeballs.
I'm going to take wrist.
Okay.
I don't want to live without my eyes.
Casey, you and I are eating.
Yep.
Really?
Really?
People want to die than
26 to 74.
Yeah, it's not even close.
Oh, that's fucked up.
You don't have to die. You can go to the hospital and get fixed.
Yeah, I suppose.
Your sight, you can never fix. Coconut or spoiled milk.
Oh, dude, this is the worst one,
too.
Ones. Is it the white one?
Yeah, the plain white.
Yeah, let
me get plain Jane.
No, that's not it. You don't want a barfer.
No, it's a white one.
Yeah.
All right. Bottoms up.
Pick your pills.
Oh God, here it is again.
Right when I bite into it.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
I feel the bad tasting ones are really stronger flavor, where the good ones are just like...
You know what makes it worse? There's creamer in my coffee. So it's like mixing.
Jay? Oh, Jay looks like he's about to blow.
Dude, that's
Santa's
really
Santa's about to blow fucking snow.
That one is the worst one.
Awesome. I'm glad
I need a minute. Hold on.
I'm caught up. Yeah. Dog food ain't so fucking bad. Mad Max, he ate dog food to survive. Well, the Road Warrior. In Road Warrior, he ate, him and that Australian cattle dog ate the fucking dog food to survive, both of them.
That fucking rotten milk taste.
Dude, that was really bad.
That is the worst one. I had it twice.
I almost gagged. I almost gagged. That was pretty bad. I hope I never get that
this
one again.
This is awesome. Thank you for having me on your show.
Oh, that milk one is so bad. That is
the worst. Know what? This game, it's not so bad when somebody else is doing it. Like, oh, I'm not the fucking dick.
Suffering.
I'm not eating the
shit. I'm kind of hoping to get the toothpaste one just to get the taste out of my mouth.
I don't know if I can do that milk one again. That was horrible.
I know. That barf one. Wait till you try that.
All right, boys. Would you rather
try the barf one?
Uh-uh.
Would you rather die from dehydration or die from starvation? I'm going to go starvation because dehydration is so much worse.
I'm going to agree with Jay. Starvation.
Yeah, starvation.
Oh, we all lost.
Yeah. Here, I haven't spawned in a while.
Come on, Jay. Ooh, that's a good one. Motherfucker.
Buttered popcorn or rotten egg, which both options are terrible.
Oh, man. What's that? Yellow. The fucking yellowish looking fucking piece of shit.
The plain yellow with no spots. Even the popcorn tastes gross, so it doesn't really matter.
I think that's a spoiled milk, isn't it?
No, it's white, right? Or yellowish.
Oh, yeah, it is yellow.
Yeah, yellowish.
What was it again? Popcorn or what?
Rotten egg. Oh, that's rotten egg. No, last time I had popcorn. That was gross, too.
Yeah, I can't tell if it's shitty popcorn. It's St. Herb Rogenbacher or whatever his name is.
Orville.
Yeah,
Orville. Remember we had to help him move an oven out of the fucking where we worked before?
Oh, I almost fucking puked.
Remember that?
Wait, what?
That old guy that we had to move that oven out of where we worked.
Oh, yeah.
And I said, we just helped Orville Rogenbacher.
Yeah. Someone got popcorn. Really you did. Yeah, you got popcorn. I could smell it.
No, it's like a mild fucking taste.
Yeah. Oh, man. Ew. That was bad. And this really tastes like rotten eggs. It just tastes like shit.
Would you rather always poo corn kernels or always have asparagus urine? Who fucking cares?
Dude, poop.
Yeah, poo the corn kernels. What, that doesn't affect
me. I'm going to take asparagus.
All right.
Because it cleans your
pee. You're going to be a rebel.
Hammer, you're eating. Should I seal my own fate?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Is it the barf? Oh, it's the barf one again.
I'm scared.
Wait, is that the one? No, that's the strawberry one. This is the barf one.
What do you know?
Because it's the clear one. It's like, it has a different... I went to art school.
Oh, it is darker.
I paid for... You know, it's working out some... Please don't be barf. I just see this fear of depression.
Yeah, it's barf.
It's the sadness wash over him.
It's madness.
These are disgusting.
I know.
Would you rather? Maybe it was not a peach because it's not that strong. I don't have that shitty aftertaste.
Oh, really?
They're all terrible.
Yeah, they're all just fucking god awful. All
right. Would you rather kill somebody and nobody knows or not kill somebody but everyone thinks you did?
Kill somebody.
I'd rather not. I couldn't have it on my conscience.
Oh, man.
If everybody thinks you did. Well, I don't know. You're probably like... Definitely going to heaven if you die and everybody treats you like shit, but you're the person didn't do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm definitely going not
to heaven. I think that would make life harder.
What, if you did kill someone?
If everybody thinks you did.
Yeah, it would definitely make life...
No jobs, no friends, no fucking anybody.
Actually,
nobody's going to want to hang out. Nah. You're going to wish you were dead.
That's a good argument. I'd say, yeah, kill people, kill someone.
I'm not. I'm going not. Oh man, it wasn't even a fucking question.
Yeah.
24.
Eat that barf.
To 76.
Eat that barf, bitch.
Oh, he did.
Oh my god, it is too. Grab me the barf peach.
It's the dark
lighter
ones.
One.
No, the dark ones you said.
The clearer ones.
Yeah, it's like clear.
Is it?
Yeah, it's okay. That one. Yeah, the one you got.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's the strawberry or whatever the fuck. That's called.
I'm starting to think this thing's rigged because it's only giving us a couple
no,
options.
No, I just got a good one, and before I got that popcorn one, so it wasn't that bad. That's barf. That was barf.
Is it?
That's the worst.
I'm the only one that hasn't tried the barf yet.
Hey, you know, you can probably keep this right here.
You're like, oh, it fits nice. Oh, yeah, is it barf or peach?
He said it's barf.
No, it's barf.
Is it worse
than the milk one?
Nope, the milk is by far, and the rotten egg's close second.
Yeah, I didn't do the milk.
Oh, the milk is really bad. Oh,
I'm
man.
A guest. They treat him accordingly.
All right.
What's the next one here?
Would you rather pour boiling hot liquid gold over your head like in Game of Thrones, or be chopped up inch by inch from feet up?
Ugh.
Both are terrible.
I'll take
gold. The gold one by Game of
feet
Thrones.
Feet up. That's rough.
I think the gold really will be faster.
Yeah, the gold would be a lot faster. And it's fucking Game of Thrones.
But, see, I think maybe bleed out. Because once it got to your ankle, there's no...
Yeah,
I mean, if
that's
they, like,
true.
Healed you, once like, the... did it with a sword stuck in fire. So
yeah.
Melted, you know, it
so
shut,
it singed you off.
But
yeah.
You didn't die.
Yeah.
That'd be horrible. But I think if you bleed out... I mean, I'm going to say chopped. What are you guys saying?
Pot
Game
of gold.
Of
I'm going gold.
Yeah, I'm going
Game
the gold
of Thrones,
one.
Okay. I lost.
Yeah, you're up, Hammer.
77-23. Come on, good taste and shit. It's in the middle. You want me to spin again?
Yeah, spin again. Go ahead, spin again.
It's in the middle again. I don't think it works in there.
One more time?
Yeah, go for it.
Like, I don't think it works in there.
Right there, boom. Chocolate pudding or...
Dog food again?
Food. That's oh, the third yeah. One. Mad Max.
All right, just because we haven't done it, the next one that loses, I'm calling the toothpaste or the blueberry
okay.
thing.
All right, we'll do that. Did you get barf or pudding?
Pudding, but I think we all lose. We're getting diabetes.
All right, next is, would you rather have the ability to swap genders whenever you want or the ability to change your age whenever you want?
Age.
Oh, dude, I'm going gender because I want to be able to play with my own titties.
Yeah, not because you worship dick and everything.
Well, you know that too. Oh, I lost big time.
You
lost
big time.
Oh, he's doing the toothpaste
blue. We're doing blue.
Oh,
what is it again? Toothpaste or what?
Toothpaste or berry blue?
Well, it's a win-win to me.
You're like, I love fucking toothpaste.
Yeah. You know how much berry blue fucking drink I drink?
I can't tell.
Yeah, that was like the rotten egg one with the popcorn.
It's berry blue.
It doesn't look like you're suffering.
No, it's berry blue.
Take a barf.
The next one, we'll do is
barf.
The green. Yeah, we didn't do
we'll do the green, yeah, lime or lawn clippings.
We didn't do the grass clippings yet.
All right, next one is
like the worst.
Would you rather have to kill the animal for any meat you eat or never eat meat again? Kill the fucking animal.
Fuck yeah. What fucking vegetarian piece of shit came up with that one?
Yeah, that one
we
even,
won, yeah.
Even close.
60-40. Well, we're going
to bet. All right, would you rather tattoo a penis on your forehead or streak every major sporting event final and get punched in the balls every time?
Streak.
Nah, I don't know.
You want a dick tattooed on your forehead?
Streak.
Tattoo
dick
a penis
tattooed.
To your forehead.
Dick tattooed.
You going dick tattooed? I'll go streak.
We won.
Casey, you got to pick the group. Grab
dude,
a group.
Why would you want to get it punched in the balls at every sporting event?
They're getting
because
a dick tattooed on
your
forehead.
You're getting a dick tattoo on your fucking
God,
forehead.
God, people are retarded.
Like, does it any racist dick tattoo? any majority nationality?
All right. What other ones?
I got
not?
Grass, but it doesn't taste bad at all.
Yeah.
Like, it smells.
All right,
like,
make them eat a barf.
All right, we'll do the other. The next tastes, one will be juicy pear or booger.
It tastes like I went out on a nut.
I can't eat that.
It's too sticky.
Well, I guess you better get the next answer, right?
Dude, that tastes like I just went out and smelled fresh air when someone mowed the grass. Like, it doesn't, it's not
oh,
bad.
Oh, yeah, wintergreen? I'm sure that's good for you.
Grass.
What's with all the gender shit? I'm thinking people are seriously confused. All right, would you rather be...
Of course I can't even find what bathroom to use.
Would you rather be the opposite gender but be handsome or beautiful, or be the same gender but be ugly?
Opposite
and beautiful.
Yeah.
Especially
a
woman.
Hot girl.
Yeah, you get away
I'd
someone.
Rule.
Yeah.
I'd have everything paid for.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, yeah, it wasn't even a
81
question.
81 to
19. 81 to 19.
Like, no shit.
We already
what
did that one.
You mean live
one.
Life perfect? Oh, my God.
We already did that one.
Have pools and shit.
Yeah, I know. Fuck, yeah.
Would you rather speak everything in surround sound or have your own theme song play whenever you enter a room? Fucking theme
own
song.
Own theme song.
Theme song.
Vader.
Yeah,
Vader.
Yeah.
All right. 89 to 11.
Yeah. That was easy.
Yeah, we did that one.
That'd be fucking awesome.
I know, dude.
In fact, next time I'm on the show, I'd like my own fucking... All right, Hammer's back.
You, you sort of did get your own theme.
Sledgehammer, right? What is that, Peter Gabriel?
Yeah, yeah. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Would you rather not wear shoes for the rest of your life or not drive a car for the rest of your life?
Shoes.
Not drive a car.
you don't drive now.
Shoes.
I'm going car.
Wait, not have a car for the rest of your life.
I can find rides.
Shoes.
I need shoes.
Your fucking stinky feet always be exposed.
I can't.
Get strong.
They wouldn't be stink because air would always be
in
it.
It would be like caveman. You'd have like really thick calluses.
I got it.
I mean, imagine going to, you're not getting a job.
Those
like,
slave,
oh, this requires to wear
feet.
Fucking steel toe boots. Sorry, sir. You can't fucking work here. So you're going to be jobless the rest of your life.
I've got to have shoes. Not wear shoes. 40. Okay, well, hammer.
All right. Fucking life choice.
Yeah, motherfucker.
Fucking life choice getting shit on me. It's in the middle. Or it's cotton candy. Or what's that?
Yeah, cotton candy.
Caramel corn or moldy cheese.
Hey, we haven't done that one yet.
Right, which one is it?
I'll take moldy cheese. Caramel, caramel, and moldy cheese.
All right. It's the pink one, I think, isn't it?
No.
No.
Oh, yeah, maybe this.
Hang on.
It looks like light yellow.
They got a fucking...
I think it's this one?
They got a fucking...
Yep.
No, I think it's the pink one. Pink one's cotton candy.
Pink one's barf or peach.
No.
It's these really light-colored ones.
No, that's the popcorn one.
Here,
this. No, this one's not
popcorn.
It's the
pink
one.
Where do you see pink, though?
Right there. Hold on. Let me see this fucking thing. Yeah.
This is it.
They need to label these shit.
The moldy cheese.
That's pink, dude.
Look. That's yellow, right? Look, it's on the sides, too. Look at the sides. Right here. Caramel corn or moldy cheese.
It's this, right here.
It might be pink. You might be right.
I don't know. That looks like the popcorn one.
The popcorn one doesn't have any spots.
Are you positive?
Yeah, look right here.
HIV positive.
Right there.
I don't know. You fucking do it. I'm confused.
Right here. See?
I'll go with Jay.
That's cool. Just do it. Whatever.
Yeah, whatever. Just
do
eat,
it live.
Eat the fucking thing.
Agreed?
Yeah. Eat it.
Oh, you take one too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you both
I
lost.
I pick them. Motherfucker.
Mine's cheese. Absolutely, that's cheese.
Is it moldy cheese?
Oh, yeah.
But it's... you like blue cheese, so it doesn't even
no,
taste
No, it
like...
doesn't taste like blue cheese. You know that... that
mine's good, so I got caramel.
Yeah. You know that musty smell?
Mm-hmm.
That when something's moldy?
Yeah, my
it tastes just like that.
All right, which one haven't we done yet? The pink one, right?
Yeah, we got to do the pink one yet.
All right, how about one more, and then... Is that good? How are we on time?
Oh, I think we ran late.
Oh, okay, whatever.
It's 3 o'clock,
so we know what it feels like
anyway.
For a woman to be on the period.
That I'm here.
All right, this is our last one.
Soaking in.
Live 1,000-year life or live 10 100-year lives?
Wait, say that again.
Would you rather live 1,000-year life or live 10 100-year lives?
10 100, because it would change it up.
Yeah, what would your body look like after 1,000
I know,
years?
Yeah, fuck
would
that.
Like,
yeah, I'll go for 10 100.
You'd look like Amy Schumer trying to play Barbie.
Gross.
I love her. Could you not make fun of her?
All right, we were right on that. We need one more. Would you rather rip off your own arm or rip off your own leg? I go with arm.
Arm.
Agreed.
Same. All right.
You can still finger blast a girl with the other one.
Only be able to get a haircut once every 2 years. Only be able to shower once every 2 months.
Haircut.
Haircut. Jesus. Fight for Germany in World War I or fight for Germany in World War II?
Two. I can beat Hitler.
I would go with one.
Two's more modern. You're fucking riding.
Yeah,
yeah, I'd rather get hit by a tank shell than die slowly from gas.
Oh, it was more the fact that the moral aspect of it.
It was cooler war. World War II was cooler war.
I won. You two are wrong. Do the pink one and we're done.
You can meet Hitler. Hitler wasn't a bad guy. He killed Hitler. What is it now? The pink one?
Yeah,
the pink one.
Switch. Yeah, it's the same thing. But why? All right, no balls. Switch. Woot. What is it again? Tutti Frutti?
No, it's like the peach.
Or Stinky Socks.
Yeah, pink was one we didn't try, right?
It was the
strawberry. Stinky Socks. Yeah, it tastes like cotton.
Yeah, okay.
Or maybe we did try that one.
Way to go, thank you.
Ew, it doesn't taste like
help
cotton.
Help me out, bro. Woo!
Looks like it's... Oh, it tastes like I'm sucking Michael Jordan's dick in a Hanes t-shirt.
That was a random and particular... We picked him right out.
Oh, all right, folks. Well, that's all the time we have today for our Christmas special. Special thanks to Mark Hammer for joining us on our show today.
Thank you. Thank you. It was an honor. Fucking awesome.
It's been a good time.
Yep.
Hope
we had fun, Hammer.
Sledgehammer.
Yeah, you know, my freaking thing turned off.
He's slacking. I'll just help you out.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, so thank you, everyone, again, and Merry Christmas.
There we go.
There it is. Happy Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, whatever the fuck you celebrate.
I'll be back.
All right. See y'all next week.
Have a good one.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.